Alrighty, it's time, Heartland, episode 2. Let's get back into it. But let me tell you something. I am running on below average, not terrible sleep, but below average sleep. Hopefully I will not make any dreadful mistakes as a result of that, or hopefully I won't be completely silent as well. I took a 200 milligram caffeine pill and I got this big old jug of Mountain Dew here. Hopefully that will kick in and keep me going. I'm also hoping to record an additional 2 episodes after this, so I'm going to record 2 episodes of Nightmare Zone, 2 episodes of Heartland, and I'm going to let 2 of those episodes render and upload overnight, and hopefully that'll catch me up and I won't have to stay up late in order to stay on task, basically. Anyways, I got one shout-out, and that's to Nige's gaming channel, and he also is a Nightmare Zone YouTuber, and out of all the commenters, he's definitely the most noble, the most regal of all of our commenters. His manner of speaking and his accent elevate him above the common rabble. So, I love his accent. Like, people say I have a nice speaking voice. I believe he is a disc jockey or he's a radio personality. And, he has a really good voice. So let's... And my alarm is going off. Everything always trying to ruin my show.
This gives me a good chance to ask Santos what's really going on around here.
Okay, is it? Oh my gosh.
I'm here if you need me.
I will definitely keep that in mind.
Okay. All this dialogue. Is that a plague sample we forgot?
Want me to come along?
Sure.
That's great.
We'll use the buddy system. Does this guy have a weapon? Oh, we got a new cardio skill. Acrobatics, no. Backpacking, yes. This guy doesn't have a specific fighting skill, so let's go ahead and use the pipe wrench then. I guess we'll keep using the Trumbull Gatekeeper. Okay, we actually have snacks now. That's good. Let's use one of these awful painkillers. Got an infestation here. So... I kind of want to burn out that infestation. Let me grab these. And put this away. And I will carry a plague sample cure or plague cure with me. Also, let's build something. Them and their repetitive dialogue. Oh, I could remove this if I wanted to. So one thing to know is that any facility with a black outlining means it is not a permanent facility, means that we can actually remove it if we didn't want it. So if we didn't want this, for example, because it is eating one material per day, we could get rid of it. We could also upgrade it. Let's not remove anything for now. So it's kind of overwhelming. It's kind of hard to tell, like, what should we build? So what I think I want to do is just kind of just pick something. And I don't care if it's a bad idea or not. When I'm overwhelmed with choices, typically my strategy is let's just pick something. So that looks like a good option, the outpost upgrade. That needs a specific person.
Found a base as big as this one.
The generator, this looks interesting right here, the utilities complex. So none of these look like things I want to build right now, so instead let's upgrade this. Check the fuel status. This is... We definitely want to take the survey car. Let's borrow both of these. Might bring one extra fuel with us. Because I know this, this car goes through fuel relatively quickly. Not insanely fast, but... Got a feral, and maybe we should clean this area out of freaks first? I've heard some people saying that the enemies can get a bit dangerous if you allow them to pile up. I cannot see anything, though. It is so dark. He's like 22 meters away, and I still can just... Okay, there he is. Look for his glowing eyes. Fortunately, the blood plague causes people to glow in the dark. Very, I think that's him there. The metal railing is blocking me. Terrain isn't cooperating either. Okay, that's him right there. I think I hit his body. I'm surprised that he doesn't detect us at 40 meters because I was just forced to stand up. Guy has stealth, so we are able to eliminate regular zombies pretty efficiently. There he is. Every time I aim, he stops moving. Or he starts moving. Oh my gosh. Okay, he sees us. We're just gonna have to fight him in melee combat. Okay, that should be the end of him. Melee combat seems like, especially with blunt weapons seem to be pretty good against ferals. It's not all that surprising. Ah, that sucks. I really wanted striking. What are the skills of my other community members? She's undetermined.
My teacher never let me draw dinosaurs in class. I hope the zombies ate Mr. Howard first.
I guess we'll go with swordplay. Or we could do CQC. I think I'm gonna go with CQC. CQC can also be pretty good against ferals if you can stun lock them. Daylight is also coming back, so although I was kind of like, oh man, I'm kind of wasting time fighting these guys, but honestly, it's fine so that we actually get some daylight.
Okay, that's a lot of dead guys in one place.
Alrighty. Now that we're getting light back, we're going to be able to drive more off-road.
Hey, thanks for including me on this. You're not the only one who wants to do right by Lily.
Sure, kid.
Man, it's so mountainous.
We'll see it through together.
Yo, just a reminder. We're almost out of fuel here.
Let's go around, because we'll probably get trapped in that rocky area. Look at all these interesting trees. I'm going back through the cornfields again. I wonder if the cornfields damage me. Look at all these curiously narrow trees. What kind of trees are these? Like, I mean, like, we don't have anything like that where I live.
Welcome back. Glad to see you're doing well.
Right back at you, Ray.
Now that we have CQC, we don't have to worry about our weapon breaking down, since this weapon is indestructible.
We need your help, but you may discover things you wish you didn't know. Are you ready to learn more?
Yeah, I knew there was something going on here.
Alright, then here's what you need to know. Not long ago, the military came rolling into the valley with a lot of people and supplies. This wasn't like the quarantine back during the outbreak. They came in here to destroy something, something big. Instead, as best we can tell, they were wiped out.
Christ, what the hell did they run into?
They had an outpost near Marshall. I figure that'd be a good place to look for clues. So, are you ready to investigate the abandoned military outpost?
I'm in. Just tell me where to go.
Excellent, my friend. Welcome to the team. But I can't let you go out there without backup. That's why I'm sending Keisha along with you.
Seriously? You're letting me do this?
You're ready for it. Good luck to you.
All right, kid. Follow me.
You know, man, every day is better than yesterday with you guys around.
See what they have to sell.
You interested in trading?
Sounds good.
Nothing mind-blowing. I don't feel like looting right now. Let us get on with it. So we have supply run. That's probably an optional objective. Let's destroy this. That'll give daylight even more time to rise up. Get in. I don't know how important it is. Can I drive through these trees? Yes, I can. I don't know how, with some of these new art assets, which of these will be considered an impassable object and which of them will not be considered an impassable object.
Look, I'm sorry we couldn't say more earlier. We're not too good about trusting strangers around here.
Yeah, I'd have done the same in your shoes.
So I guess these are going to be plague infested. Our ammo is not as good as it could be, so let us attempt to thin some of these guys out where possible.
I catch my breath.
Let's shoot one of them. His death will cause a little bit of sound. And that should cause them to come out a little bit more. Where is the screamer? This guy's getting too nosy. You're not the screamer. It's like I'm playing this like it's Nightmare Zone. But at the same time, I don't know how dangerous it is. We're looking for the screen. Ah, there he is. That one looks unique.
Not setting up an outpost here.
Got him. All right, into regular combat. Could be something good here, so let's check real quick.
Better than nothing.
Classic crossbow. I think we need that. I'll take a spare weapon.
I can actually use this.
Fuel is always nice. It's like I got so many habits from playing Nightmare Zone that are hard to kick. I don't know, maybe I'm overestimating the difficulty of it. Maybe I could just... Maybe I could literally just play it like it's,
I'll need to use that one again.
Standard Zone. Because it's Standard Zone, I would just literally just run in there and just beat the crap out of them. There would be no questions asked. Ugh, the car's too far away. I don't want to run back and forth that much. How's my ammo looking? We got about 15 shots. We don't need any of that.
All clear.
Ammo is fine. Food.
I guess that's it.
There we go. We do want those light bolts, but let's come back to it. Take the plague sample. Oh, I put the car on the other side. Wow, we are running out of inventory quickly. I want those bolts, but I don't want to drop anything that I've got for it. I'll drop the firecrackers. Those are really cheap to make. Oh my god, out of my way. There we go. So a lot of people seem to be disappointed that this is a standalone expansion. Let's pass this off to you. You can carry it. Because I don't want the extra weight. And I understand that. I understand that people wanted this to be like a full-fledged map. I was hoping that after you beat the game, it would be just that. You would actually gain access to it. And, I mean, I don't know if it works that way or not. I'm assuming the answer is no. But, I do understand why people want a full-fledged map with multiple bases. People are asking, you know, what do I think of it so far? Way too early to say. I've only been playing for 1 hour or so. Definitely not enough time for me to give you a good idea. I could say preliminary thoughts is that I like the idea of coming back. I like seeing the evolution of the Blood Plague. I'm a little disappointed that there isn't a completely new zombie. Now, it might be too... Maybe there's a secret zombie in the campaign that they haven't revealed to us yet, but... Blood Plague variations, I think, are fine. But, I think they also should, include at least one brand new type of zombie. There is nice and flat. I really like this. I mean, like, why can't there... This is kind of like a Mare Valley feel to it. I love how easy it is to drive through here. This is where my favorite base was in the original State of Decay. Oh, no, it's not. It's further south. There was this giant warehouse, and that was like... Or at least what I considered to be the best base location. Let's get out and check this. Nothing. Now we'll have to fight these guys.
Can't do it.
Why can't I use the shove? Don't I have CQC? Yeah, I should be able to use the shove. Okay, there we go. Give me the sample. Oh, ah, whatever, it's just one sample. I'm in the middle of something.
Adorable.
I'll give some more of my thoughts about it after we looks like a plague heart.
The army guys abandoned it when it got overrun.
Christ, overrun is an understatement.
You're not getting cold feet, are you?
Not on your life.
We do not have the correct ordnance. We will need to create an outpost. Let's just create an outpost temporarily. I don't care what the bonuses are. Permanent safe area. Permanent safe area. Do we have the influence for it? Yes, we do. Looks like I need to turn my computer volume off. That doesn't interfere with the recording. Wow, how do I get- okay, there's an entrance. Sneakity sneak sneak. That's the sound of stealthy gameplay.
No more deadheads around here.
Yay, where is the- okay, right. Create an outpost.
Consider this outpost ready to go.
Now we'll loot. Actually, I can empty my inventory now. Let's just put all our crap away for now, and then we can kind of like reorg- well, not my bullets. Oh, fuel generator. A whole lot of stuff in here, jeez. So what we need are some explosives in order for this. We'll probably have to craft some though, I don't think we have any. Let's see. Yeah, we don't have any. Let's see what our options are for the creation of weapons. Our options are quite poor, it seems. I guess we could try soda bombs. I've never tried soda bombs. It only uses... Wow, those are really cheap and inexpensive. Shoot, let's just make a... three of them, I guess? That'll give us 9 soda bombs. I'd be surprised if 9 soda bombs can't kill a Plagueheart. Okay. I don't know if I'm being overly cautious or not. That's one thing that I... because, like, I'm so used to playing on Nightmare Zone that... and then since this is, like, uncharted territory, I'm not sure if I'm being excessively cautious or not. The first thing we want to do, since we're not using a scent blocker attack... we're gonna want to thin out the enemies first. I see a screamer, I detected a screamer, rather. That's him right there. The first thing I'm gonna do is go through the perimeter and begin thinning the zombies out. Because when the Plagueheart calls for reinforcements, it's going to be too much of a problem to just...
I need a break.
We can't just permit them to just pour in and swamp us.
I gotta rest for a second.
I climb on top of this. Let's just go off here. Oh wow. I'm still in stealth too. Ah, get out of my way. Thank you for interrupting me. People wonder why I don't bring people with me. People wonder like, oh, why don't you bring like allies with you? I'll tell you why. It's because the fox operates alone. Let's check the other side of the plague art. See a lot of them over there. Let's eliminate this guy who wandered away.
This place is hotter than a damn sauna.
Well, we just learned another thing about Plagueheart lore. Apparently they raise the temperature of the area. Does that mean they are possibly vulnerable to cold temperatures? Let's not open that door, because there could be a zombie right on the other side of it. Even though it appears like a good idea, because then we could go around them, but if we take a few extra seconds, we can go the long way. The heart must be inside this room. Yes, that's where it typically is in, Okay. We've nearly cleared the premises. Stamina back. Go hot on him. Oh, let me pick up the plague sample. You know what? We'll just pick him up later. Do one last pass. I want to take one last look around to make sure. Miss anyone? How you doing? What are you doing here? This a art project of yours? Well, I think it's time you take a rest. Okay, I guess we're gonna find out how good, soda bombs are on... man, it's... I don't want to blow myself up. Looks like a decent distance. Let's bounce it about right here.
Sure didn't like that.
Yes, just get closer to it. What a brilliant strategy. It's not like I'm currently blowing it up with, like, makeshift hand grenades. I forgot that this is not Nightmare Zone. It's not like some ungodly quantity of reinforcements. These AI are so stupid.
That was terrifying.
Let's look around and get out of here.
Excellent. An upgrade to a high-quality backpack.
I know, man. Every day is better than yesterday.
A pistol. Oh, okay. We got stims. Those are very good. These will stack. The chef's knife we can leave behind. Let's use one of these. I said use one of these. But we can probably leave those behind. Ugh, we're gonna have to loot something and pick the item up, so let's go back to the vehicle. Let's also move the vehicle closer to us. Oh, we have a- I forgot we got that outpost. Forgot a little about that. Just dump all this in here. So, a note to self, the soda bombs are kind of a last resort. They were pretty cheap. I mean, I'm not gonna knock the soda cans. They weren't- they performed acceptably. They did as well as I thought they'd do. Can we squeeze in here? Yes. Yes, we can. Just strip this area down of anything useful. R12 import. I've never seen this before. Full auto assault shotgun on the AK. Okay, never mind. I recognize the description.
Holy shit! Take a look at this.
Is that what I think it is?
Oh yeah, this'll come in very handy.
Give him. Oh, everyone is full on rucks. Okay. Give me the rucks. Well, at least we're gonna get some backpacking EXP, which is a really good skill. Throw all this stuff in here. Once again, I don't know if I was being overly cautious about the plague heart. Like, I don't know, could I have just gone in there guns blazing? I am not familiar with what I should expect for difficulty.
I can actually use this.
Good stuff. I'm not used to how I feel like this is even more generous than the game. Than, like, just standard zone. I don't feel like you would find this much stuff even in the base game's lowest difficulty. Like, this seems to be, like, extra generous. Maybe it's because I'm told that there is a limited amount of time that you can realistically survive because you'll eventually just completely run out of resources. Unless it's possible to negate your resource losses. Aha! Military journal fragment. Day one, establish FOB at illegible. The doc is super creepy when she's excited. Day two, Wen swears he can see the wall grow. I said he was full of crap, and everyone laughed. Everyone except the captain. Day three, made contact with local survivors at illegible violent resistance. Patrols ordered to avoid individuals identified as the Wilkerson family. Day four, my patrol in the city. Damn. Wasn't lying. We're gonna need more ordnance. Trying to get me demonetized. Day five, I demonetized hate plague zombies. Day six, there's demonetization in this valley I've never seen. Why does the doc not seem surprised? Day seven, Wen's dead, so are Kukus and Russell, and the doc's acting like it's all normal. Demonetization. The captain says we're going back in tomorrow. Beth, I'm sorry about how we left things. If I don't see you again, journal ends.
Found something. Looks like part of a journal. It sounds like they ran into something nasty.
how about we bring that back to Ray rather than standing around in here?
Works for me.
Let's throw this stuff back in and pull out some emergency stuff like the repair kit in case something really stupid happens to our vehicle. I never put it past this game to cause something really give me a toolkit. What's up with this guy? He's like, asleep on the job? You could have helped me. But, oh, wait. Oh, wait, I was gonna try to jump it. That wasn't as exciting as I thought it would be. Oh my god, medkit, that was a... Thank you there, I take back everything I said about you. Very good, very good. Okay, let's get out of here. In order to destroy these plague arts more effectively, we're gonna need power for pipe bombs. Utility vehicle, plague jug. None of those are too relevant to us, though. We can ignore them. Tight squeeze, get around it. All these barricades here forcing me to go around them. Well, you can chase me if you want, juggernaut. Use the exercise. Oh my god, I'm not used to these! I'm not used to these corn, like the cornfields you can just... This is interesting. The plane is overgrown. Ah, the plane was already there in State of Decay. As I drove closer to it, it looked like they were adding a red color filter to it. So like, why is it growing around the plane? Like, did the plane carry something? And maybe that was like an epicenter or for a vector point for the plague? Maybe it wasn't overgrown in the first game because it takes time for it to develop? Very interesting.
Welcome home, my friend.
Would it kill you to be as friendly as they are, even once in a while?
Yes.
It might.
Well spoken, Quincy. I'm starting to like you now. Is this supposed to be brick? I don't know.
I'm glad you all made it through. Did you find anything out there?
Just wait till you hear this.
This journal you found, it confirms my worst suspicions. You should hold on to it for now. Something very bad is going on in this valley, and I fear the worst is yet to come.
Oh, damn it, Lily. How'd I let you talk me into this?
Hey, before you go, can we talk?
Very well. Speak your piece, Keisha.
He's a good guy, but I want to see real action. Could I join your team?
Wow, he's like right next to you. Well, why don't we take the advice of the guide and just accept everyone? Sure, welcome aboard.
Really? Thank you. Thank you so much.
I had a feeling this day was coming. Don't worry, Keisha. I'm not upset. We'll miss you, of course, but you have to do what you think is right. We'll be here if you need us, and that goes for both of you.
Our ammo supply is getting very low.
Sounds like we have a juggernaut. Let's quick loot some of this stuff.
Thanks for giving me this chance. I am totally ready to see some action.
We can sell that back to him immediately.
Ease down a bit, okay?
Sure thing, boss.
And I'm like, what's with all these over-eager people?
Yeah, I got no room for that.
You ready to Interesting, so he regards her as close to a daughter. Sell that. We'll keep these in case they're needed for some advanced construction.
This spot's all tapped out.
Definitely take that. It could be useful for advanced construction. Okay, let's go stealth since I don't remember where that juggernaut is. Let's mark his location. There's really no need to fight him. We're only going to get 50 influence for killing him. Waypoint back to... What is this objective? The supply run? Let's hit the supply run.
I've got another juggernaut here.
Get in! Oh my gosh. He's... Oh, man. This is why, even in Nightmare Zone, I prefer to go by myself. Okay. One of the neat tricks with CQC is if you push someone from behind, they automatically fall down. Very useful for crowd control in larger fights with teammates. Of course, in one-on-one combat, it's easier just to stab him in the head. Don't have much room for anything, so unfortunately we won't be taking a whole lot with us. We're basically just looking for the mission objective. Do I have scouting? No, I have stealth.
I can't carry any more crap.
Where are all the lootables? Here we go.
I can actually use this.
There's a lot of decent stuff, but... Well, not decent stuff, but... It's stuff. Can we change characters? No.
Now why doesn't that
there we go. More often? If you're new to the channel, you will quickly learn that I do not hoard items. If I gotta leave stuff behind, then I leave stuff behind. I know it drives some people nuts, but... Don't forget that time is its own resource. Oh, God! Oh, man. That could have gone worse. Let me not assume that everything is a drive in the park. Okay, I don't know what I hit there. Nice shallow area to drive up. Taking these weird routes are nice because the survey car is going to reveal a bunch of, like, just random places.
Hey, I just delivered a load of cool stuff.
Three snacks and some basic painkillers. Very good, I suppose.
But it's home.
I promise I won't let you down.
I can't believe we found a base as big as this one.
Oh my god. Is she going to say that throughout the entire game?
Wise delivered.
What's up, Quincy?
That. Okay, we're overflowing on materials, so.
I'm an expert at making things go boom. Let me upgrade that lab and prove it.
Let's go ahead and do this. This will also get us below the... before our materials fall apart, so let's just get that upgrading. Man, now everyone wants to contact me and call me and text me, like, why can't you do it when I'm not recording? Curse you! Alright, so let's see what we actually chose to upgrade, now that I'm safer inside the base. The demolitions lab, it's going to allow us to craft ammo, advanced explosives, and firearms mods. Interesting. Let's clear some of these freaks out nearby and secure the general premises of the premise of the base. Not premises, that is not the correct word! Or was it the correct word? Am I doubting myself? We can actually just shoot through this window. Ah! The dinosaur!
Stay out of that cloud.
Interesting. Quite gross looking. I wonder if it's still flammable.
That won't work.
Ah, I couldn't dodge, even though I was mashing the B button. And he interrupts me. Fine. I'll give him a little room.
Zed's got nothing on me.
Okay. Premises, that was the correct word. It's funny when there are words that you use, and you use them, and then when you start to overthink it, you start to doubt yourself, and then you're like, wait a second, is that... But no, that it was right the first time. It was right the first time.
Can I tell you a secret? I've wanted to live here since I was 5.
Oh my. What an important secret. So who should we play as? Probably, oh. You know. Striking. So they're kind of reversed in their skills. Well, we definitely need someone with striking, so. Because striking is essential for fighting ferals.
To have all that empty space just sitting there.
Yes, yes, the empty space, etc. Let's upgrade to the 7-slot backpack. All these notes we've gotten, I guess we're kind of amassing a little bit of lore. What should we do? Look for more building materials, I suppose? Get your tiny claws on this. T-Rex espresso, a new evolution in coffee, I'm sure. Stego Saver, prehistoric savings, modern wants. Uh-huh. First aid station. Oh, well, that's just a mark for the wrong way. I'll tell you who's going the wrong way. Well, actually, it's not lying. I don't think you could pass through here. Is this thing upgraded yet? No, and we don't. Oh, well, we do have the manpower. I mean, what should we build? Okay. Let's look at our losses.
Hello there. I'd like to offer your team some rewards and some goodwill. That is, if you'll send someone over to help me with something.
I know everybody in this valley, but I've never heard that voice before. Be careful, okay?
I don't like the weapon that guy's using for base defense. Okay, so this is what we need to do. We need to re-equip everyone for base defense. Everyone needs to be on the proper guard duty. That is going to be a great weapon for guard duty. Now let's switch to Keisha. You just got here and you're already sleeping on the job. What the heck? What the heck? She's using a JL-94. That's actually not a terrible weapon for base defense. Let's get her some basic equipment. Not too much, though, because our stockpile isn't as good as it could be. It's not a bad weapon to defend the base with, to be honest. And let's get to Quincy. I believe he will use a shotgun. I heard some stories about people getting overran by ferals, like a squad of four of them, and computers have extreme difficulty hitting ferals because they... I believe it's because they try to aim at head height of a normal zombie. This one's slightly better, so we'll have him use that. Let's switch back to Elena.
Never thought I'd get along with folks like these, but here we are.
And now we can actually use a quiet weapon. Take one of these with us. So she has an injury. If we get into a fight with a human, I am going to want a more effective weapon. The gatekeeper will do fine, since it's silent. Low on ammo, though. But still, 11 rounds is still acceptable. What skills does she have? She's the one with scouting. That's interesting, so I might have been getting scouting data from her. Maybe that's the value of bringing someone else. If they have scouting, you can combine your skills together. Fuel level is average. We need to add a fuel tank. So he's just up the road a little bit, so... This is standard zone, so I can't get headshot. You can't be headshot by human enemies in standard zone, so I don't have to be quite as concerned about it. Nightmare zone, I am very concerned about fighting human enemies. This will probably be the last quest too before we sign out, because we're 52 minutes in. Squish this guy on entry.
Thanks for coming out to meet with me.
Let's remove this bloater. Take the headshot. Bloaters do not explode if you shoot them in the head. As a new player tip. Why am I able to sprint? I should not be able to sprint in stealth. Like, look at this. I can sprint in stealth. That is something that is exclusive to the stealth skill. I should not be able to do that with scouting. Search speed, detection range, gun durability loss. That's strange. Minus 50%? That is strange. I should not be able to do that.
Okay, we're zombie free.
All right, Captain Logan.
I just need you to make a quick pickup for me. I promise it's worth your time.
Why can't you do this yourself?
Normally I would, but I got a bit roughed up. I need to stay here for now. I just need you to make a quick pickup for me.
Hold on, are you with the military?
Classified. I just need you to make a quick pickup for me.
Fine, we'll do it.
Great. Here's the deal. There's a supply drop not far from here. That's something I need. If you bring back the encrypted note and that supply drop, you can keep whatever else you find.
Sure thing.
Interesting. Interesting. Let's look for fuel rip. Yep, fuel, I'll take it.
I found a couple of things while I was out scavenging.
We don't want to leak too much because it's making it sound like whatever we find in there is going to have a bunch of stuff in it too. So we don't want to overflow our equipment. Okay, if I'm allowed to sprint in stealth, which I'm normally not allowed to, do I get quick executions? No, I don't. Okay, I get standard executions. Weird that I can sprint in stealth. Like, that's not something I should be allowed to do. Okay, it's out in the middle of nowhere. Probably want to get on this, though, because night is beginning to fall.
Expect some resistance at the site.
Got a feral after us, but he's too slow to catch up. So is it in the swamp? Yeah, it looks like it's in the swamp. For a nice quiet area to kind of drop off. Oh, that's one thing about water is it reduces you slide a lot, you can't really get good traction. Okay, let's get out and kill these guys. I think I hear the Cleo, the iconic Cleo beacon sound.
As long as we keep making smart decisions, I see a lot of success coming our way.
This is exactly the place to look.
After that, let me know when you find the note.
Sure thing.
Juggernaut.
Zombie freak spotted.
Interesting. That makes sense. One of the things about the Cleo beacons is that they make noise. This thing looking dead tree, kind of creepy. Stop moving. Yeah, I hate how erratically they move. You see how they just constantly, like, duck around and whatnot? It makes it very Okay, so how do I want to handle this? We need to kill these guys. Okay, one. Two. What I'm probably gonna do is just make a rush for it and just grab everything I can. And then run for the car. Unfortunately, juggernauts are fairly clumsy. Take that, and that, and now run for it.
Excellent. Be sure to grab anything else that catches your eye.
I think we actually lost the juggernaut. I think we actually broke eyesight with him. Oh, juggernauts. So what I saw from the rest of it, I saw some ammo that we missed, which I think we can live without it. And another thing I saw, it looked like a mine. And I think we can live without the mine as well. Not waste any more time. I don't want it to get dark with me driving in rugged territory. The MX-1 DMR Heavy, that seems like a pretty cool weapon. Let's return to him. Let me check something. Let me check my fuel real quick. I don't want to run out of fuel at any inconvenient time, even though we are wasting a little bit of fuel. I'm gonna go for safety rather than resource efficiency. I had a comment that I need to basically fight the Juggernauts more head-to-head. I don't think I agree with that approach. Regular Juggernauts? Sure. I would have no problem fighting it in hand-to-hand combat, but a Plague Juggernaut? No, no. Terrible idea fighting them in head-to-head combat. And that's because they infect you with Blood Plague very easily because of their slam attacks. Even if you are actively running away from them, even if you are keeping your distance, it's just very easy for them to infect you with their slam attacks, and it infects you quite a bit. You get about like 25% on Nightmare Zone. Maybe it's a little more generous on a standard zone, the rate of infection, but it's quite bad news. I don't advise fighting Juggernauts in direct head-to-head combat in any situation, really.
Appreciate your help on this.
When you said we'd encounter resistance, I didn't think you meant a Juggernaut.
Yeah, sorry about that. I'm glad you're still with us.
Guy is, sketchy. What does the military want with this thing, anyway?
I'll tell you, but it's classified. Do you have the encrypted note? You've done a great service today.
I should have read the note, damn it.
I can't go into details at this time, but someday, all of Trumbull Valley will thank you for this. That's all for now. I'll be in touch later if it's required.
I should have read it. I mean, I'm sure it's encrypted, so it'd be a bunch of, like, gobbledygook that we don't understand, but I still should have read it.
So, what was that guy's deal?
No clue. Hopefully we'll have a chance to find out.
E-dokes. So if these guys are with the military, they're not Red Talon. Like, these guys, the military and Red Talon, they're separate things. Like, the Red Talon is basically a paramilitary group. This is like the actual military. Oh my gosh, Kat, I got rid of your box because you're scratching and making noise, and then you got the box back out, and now you're scratching and making noise again. Ruining my video. Hopefully the microphone doesn't catch all that banging noise. Let's get back before sundown and sign out. Darn, I really wish I read that. I was just so focused on other things that it slipped my mind. Here it is, the M4X1 DMR Heavy. Experimental M4 configuration deployed to combat the zombie threat. Fitted with a drum magazine, short scope, and suppressor for clearing hordes at range. Known to jam. The fuel in. Put the ammo in. We're slightly over our ammo capacity. Let's just use one of these to sort ammo so that we don't lose ammo randomly.
So we're holed up in a dinosaur-themed truck stop fighting the zombie apocalypse. What's next? Killer cyborgs?
Let's,
Please, my friend. You have to help.
Never mind. We'll deal with them later. Get ready, people.
Can you let them hear?
I truly apologize, but we had no other choice.
That doesn't sound good. Guess we're gonna be using this weapon. Can we make some incendiaries real quick? We can. Incendiary, gonna get the med kit. This.
That's an idiot.
The deadhead siege is underway here at base.
Can't see anything because it's, of course, it's dark. A little bit of running so they don't burn me.
Looks like the dead aren't done with this fight yet.
Oh, I'm burning my own guys. It's such as a single fire so we don't abuse our ammo.
That loader better not get any closer.
Oh, that's the barrel right there. Okay. Let's get up here. I can't see. I wish it was not nighttime. Oh god, I'm inside the... didn't see that. Fortunately, it didn't give me too much of an infection. Looks like you have to actually get caught in it for a little while.
I'm not sure we can hold out much longer.
I don't know, seems like we're doing pretty good to me. Oh, it's a 1 minute and 30 second siege though, so... Ah, when is this gonna go away? I wanna go back. Maybe we can sneak around it. There we go. Fortunately, we switched everyone to pretty good weapons. Oh, it's still like... the ground's still dangerous? Okay, even though the ground is glowing, it's not dangerous. I thought I grabbed more Molotovs than that.
That's pretty heavy.
It's like hard to defend the base when it's so dark. Jeez.
I can't let that feral take me down.
Missed him. Where is he? So hard to see. Oh, there he is. I don't want to burn the cars because I know cars take damage from fire as well. Oh my god, it's so hard to hit things at night. Leave me alone, you assholes. Okay, there's one about right there. I think I overthrew. Actually, I think that was on target. Let's see if those explode. Where's that screamer at? I think he's right there. Oh god, didn't see him. Oh my god, it's so dark. It's so hard to fight because of how dark it is. I need to stay here for a moment while that cloud clears out. Oh. Where is he? I need to mark him on the map. As I thought, our allies have... no ability to fight these ferals because their accuracy is so bad and it's so dark. I have bad accuracy too. There he is. Don't need accuracy for melee combat. There we go.
A little mess is all the zombies can accomplish. You don't have much to worry about.
Take comfort that you still have a home at all, my friend.
You're lucky you didn't get any of us killed.
Okay.
You really proved yourself today. Thank you, my friend. We'll find somewhere nearby to live for the time being.
Hey, why isn't he explaining why he's even here? He should be explaining, like, why he led this, like, attack force here. The attack force wasn't honestly that bad. It's just that it was more that it was nighttime. That was really the problem. That's what was making it harder than it needed to be. Is anyone full-blown blood plague? Yes, we have a full-blown infection. But it is standard zone, and that means a full infection is 2 hours to be treated. In Nightmare Zone, it's 10 minutes. Oh, that's so much faster. Oh, wow, that's, that is so much faster. Use this crappy medical thing. Yeah, that's probably enough for him. Let's check our base condition. What's giving us water?
I'll be there soon, barring any delays.
Let's check active effects.
I'm glad you've retaken
craftsmanship, gardening.
Now, could you help us do the same?
Outpost. I don't understand what's giving us water.
I'm in. There is no way we're leaving them out in the cold.
Boost yields.
You're the only one who sees we're low on food, right?
Anyways, it's time to sign out. I'm gonna sign out right in front of the T-Rex. That'll be the tradition. Oh my god. Shut up about how big the base is. Are you going to say that the entire campaign? I understand the base. The Undead Labs really wants us to understand that the base is really big. Anyways, so what did we get done today? We got, like, some interesting stuff done. We learned some secret stuff, and I would say that the zombies definitely can become a problem at night. That would be my first line of advice for you. If it's getting nighttime, be careful. That's the issue. See how dark it is? It's like you could barely see anywhere. Aside from that, during the daytime, I would say you could be as aggressive as you want. We were able to destroy that plague heart that was right around here. Not too big of a deal. Build some soda bombs if you need to. If you can get power, you can upgrade into these radio. Oh, so that's what we mean. They are pursuit mines. That's what was inside that thing that we didn't get to fully loot. Unfortunately, there was that document, the encrypted document I didn't get to read, so that kind of blows. But like I said, it's probably a bunch of gobbledygook that we wouldn't have been able to understand anyways. Like, it's supposed to be encrypted, some stuff that only the military would get. But definitely interesting. The story is taking this idea that looks like the blood plague is, like, evolving, and they ran into something that wiped them out. I'm definitely intrigued by the story. As far as I didn't get a chance to talk about what I actually think about the current condition of the game and people's complaints, I'll have to follow that up in episode 3. Anyways, that's the end of this episode. Thanks for watching. Like this video if it was entertaining. Subscribe for future Heartland content. And of course, remember that you don't have to be good to get good.